A very good morning, students. Welcome back to the computer class. Today we are going to continue with the chapter 1, evolution of computers. In the last class we studied about the history of the computers, the calculating devices, the IT inventors. Today we are going to study about the generations of computers. Now let us understand what these generations are. Earlier the computers were very big in size, they were of the size of a room, and now the computers are very compact and they are in the form of robots also. So the difference between these two types of computers, the evolution from the big computers, from the huge computers to the compact computers, has taken a lot of time, and this time has been divided into 5 parts, and those 5 time periods are named as generations. Now see, the first generation of computers begin with in 1940 to 1956. The second generation started with 1956 till 1963. The third generation 1964 to 1971. Fourth generation 1972 till present. And fifth generation present and beyond. A huge amount of changes have been taken, the developments have taken place, and so the computers of present times have evolved. Now let us study about the first generation computers. The time period for this generation was 1940 to 1956. The circuitry used in this generation was vacuum tubes. You can see the picture of vacuum tubes here. They were very large in size, because of which the size of the computers was also very huge. The data input was given with the help of punched cards and tapes. You can see the picture of punch cards and tape here. The cards and the tapes were punched, means they had holes in them which helped in reading the input. Data output was given as printouts. Now external storage was magnetic tapes here. Whatever data was there, it was stored in magnetic tapes. You can see the picture of magnetic tapes. Language used in first generation was machine language and assembly language. Machine language is the language of zeros and ones which the computer understands. Now here are some examples of first generation computers. This is UNIVAC 1, this is ENIAC, and this is EDVAC. You can see the size of these computers, they are too big, of the size of a room. This is because of the use of vacuum tubes. Because of the size of vacuum tubes is very big, and so the computers are also very big in size. Now the key features of the first generation computers are, they used a large amount of space. Speed was measured in milliseconds. They had a very limited storage capacity. A huge amount of electricity was consumed. Limited to solving one problem at a time. At one time, these computers could solve only one problem. Then they were very costly, and a lot of heat was generated. Now we come on to the second generation computers. The time period due for this generation is 1956 to 1963. Now the circuitry that was used in second generation computers was transistors. You can see the picture of transistors here, and you can compare the vacuum tubes, they were big in size, and transistors are small in size. Now the data input again was given with the same punch cards and tapes. Data output again was printouts. External storage here was magnetic tapes again, and the language used was Fortran, COBOL and BASIC. Some improvements were made in the first generation computers so that the second generation computers were made. Now we go on to the examples of the second generation computers. See, the size is a little bit reduced. This is IBM 700 series. This is IBM 1400 series. And this is IBM 350. Now the key features of the second generation computer are, these computers consumed less space as compared to the first generation computers. The speed was measured in microseconds. This means the speed has increased. In first generation computers, it was in milliseconds, and now it is in microseconds, so the speed has increased. Huge improvement in storage capacity. Then they consumed less electricity, and also the production of heat was reduced marginally. Now we come on to the third generation computers. The circuitry used in third generation computers was integrated circuits. You can see the picture here. The data input was given with the help of keyboard. Now the keyboards came into existence. Now for the output, monitors were there in third generation. Now external storage was in the form of magnetic disks. Yes, the hard disk which are there today, they are the magnetic disks. And the language used was Pascal, Fortran and COBOL. Now some examples of third generation computers are Altair and Apple I. See, the size now is reducing. You can make that out from the pictures, that the size of the computers is reducing as the generations are moving forward. Now some key features of third generation computers are: these computers consumed less space as compared to second generation computers. Speed measured in nanoseconds, the speed is increasing. Consumed less electricity, consumption of electricity is decreasing, and the size is smaller, they're reliable and efficient. Now in this generation, sophisticated operating systems were used, and generation of less heat, and these computers required less maintenance. So you can make out that with the progressing generations, the speed is increasing, the consumption of electricity is decreasing, less heat generation is there, then size is decreasing. Initially the size was so big and now the size is reducing. Now come to the fourth generation computers. Fourth generation computers are the computers which we are using today. The circuitry used in fourth generation is microprocessors. You can see the picture of microprocessors, Intel Pentium. Data input given through keyboard, mouse and scanner. Data output with the help of monitor, printer and speaker. You can relate this generation with the present time which we are using. External storage is again magnetic disk, the hard disk which we are using, and the languages used are C++ and RDBMS. RDBMS is the storage of database. A huge amount of database can be stored with the help of RDBMS. Now a few examples of fourth generation are Cray 1, Apple 2, then the PCs, laptops and tablets which we are using today are also the example of fourth generation computers. Next we come on to the key features of fourth generation. These computers occupy lesser space compared to third generation computers. Now speed measured in nanoseconds and picoseconds. Consumed less electricity, used higher level programming languages, more sophisticated operating systems were used, commonly available as personal computers, and they are cheap and portable. So the cost is also decreasing now. They are affordable, now people can buy them, and they are portable also. You can carry from one place to another, like your laptops. Now we come on to the fifth generation computers. The period of these computers is present and beyond, means these computers are there today also and they will be there in future. The development of these computers is going on, it is in process. They are based on artificial intelligence. They use parallel processing and superconductors. Then these computers use super large scale integrated circuits. Optical fiber technology is used in the circuits. Then they understand human speech. They can recognize your speech and make out what you are saying. Then they can recognize patterns like faces and complex images. They are more user friendly. Then these perform millions of instructions in a second. The speed of computation of these computers is very, very high. And they are very expensive due to their capabilities. All the high level languages are used in the making of these computers. So, I hope you have understood the generations of computers, and your today's homework is that you have to make a PowerPoint presentation on generations of computers. Have a good day. Stay home, stay safe.